हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 858 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ग्लास। एंड वेयर आई एम सेइंग कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ग्लास, इट मींस केमिकल एंड फिजिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ग्लास। केमिकली द ग्लास मे बी डिफाइंड एज ए मिक्सचर of silicate, have a different metallic oxides, it is not having any definite formula, and in glass the main 90% constituent is lime, silica and soda ash, and rest of the 10% may be barium and zinc, selenium, chromium oxides in the form of coloring agents and for some other properties. And glass is hard, it is transparent, it is having refractive capacity, it is high electrical insulator, and also it has low thermal conductivity. Glass is vitrified, it is rigid. So these are all very important characteristic of glass. And glass is insoluble in acidic medium, but slightly soluble in alkaline, and sometimes it is seen that if it is put in alkaline medium, there may be formation of sodium hydroxide. And glass is important in the sense that it has very unique property. I have already told you, and because of that property, it is used for different purposes in the laboratories, in houses, in public places. In most of the places, glass is nowadays part of our life. And before manufacturing the glass, we have to select very carefully. That is, I call it glass making material. And these glass making materials, I have already told you, 90% is, that is silica, quartz, calcium, magnesium, all these oxides, they are carbonates, and soda ash, plus lime and silicate. So these are all very, very important material, and the other materials what we are using to get the different color, like nickel, chromium, copper, oxide, so many other oxides are there to get different type of color, because very, very beautiful ornamental colors are there for glasses, that I will be giving you the coloring of the glasses. So characteristics of glass, number one, the most important characteristics of glass can be summarized as follows. I have already told you all this, but I am giving in writing. A, its hardness, that is most important, glass is very hard. B, transparency, it is transparent. C, refractive capacity, how much light it can be reflected, that is its capacity, and that glass is having refractive capacity to refract the light. D, dispersive capacity, how it can disperse the light, that capacity. And E, high electrical insulator, it is a very good electrical insulator. And F, low thermal conductivity as compared to steel and other metallic utensils, it is having low thermal conductivity. Number two, chemically, glass may be defined as a fused mixture of silicates, alkaline and alkaline earth compounds. These are other glass constituents such as calcium oxide, magnesium oxide, tin oxide, barium oxide, lead oxide, and glass is completely vitrified product, as it is mentioned that is all this mixing is, that's why it is vitrified product. And glass has no different composition, it is not having any different formula, and it is a mixture of different constituents composition. Number three, the major ingredients in glass are sand, that is called silica also, lime and soda ash. The other raw materials may be considered to be minor ingredient. Lime, silica and soda ash still forms above the 90% of all global glasses. The other ingredients such as borax, boric acid, potash, zinc oxide are added to give certain other properties to glass. So these are called minor ingredients. So here glass is made up of major ingredients, and major ingredients more than 90% are sand, that is called silica, and lime and soda ash. And in that rest of the less than 10%, there are all these oxides, borax, boric acid, zinc oxide, and plus chromium, silicon, this nickel, all these oxides to give different type of color. So all these ingredients, they are known as minor. The major 90% is those three ingredients. So here physical and chemical properties of glasses are given. So first is, that is physical properties of glass. A, they are usually transparent and amorphous solid, they are not crystalline, they are in amorphous form, and they are amorphous solid because of its high viscosity. B, glasses are completely vitrified, it has lot of different type of components, constituents, that's why it is completely vitrified product, it has not got any different formulation, it is a mixture. Number C, next one, they are hard and rigid and have no definite melting point. Of course, the definite melting point is only possible when some compound is pure, and it is a mixture of different constituents, different chemical substances, that's why it is not having definite melting point. D, glasses have sufficiently high viscosity, and that's why, because of this high viscosity, it is not in crystalline form. E, they are insulator of heat and electricity, or we can say that for thermal conductivity and for electricity, they are acting as a good insulator with low thermal conductivity. F, they can incorporate coloring materials. This is the beauty of glass, that's why now a lot of glasses are used for ornamental purpose, for beautification, and lot of industries are there, lot of billion dollar big business of glass, coloring glass material is there with different color, and with the coloring materials with preserving transparency. And if you are mixing coloring material, may be cobalt oxide, nickel oxide, iron oxide, with different color they will produce those fluorescent color, they are not going to disturb the transparency of glass. That is the beauty of glass, and with that different color fluorescent, it will look very, very beautiful and shiny, and of course it has reflection capacity, so it will produce very good fluorescent of color to beautify it. Number five, chemical properties of glass. A, glass is not attacked by air or any oxidizing agent. B. Ordinary glass is slowly attacked by alkalis, but very resistant to acids only in presence of very strong acid, like your hydrofluoric acid. Only hydrofluoric acid can attack glass. Otherwise, other hydrochloric acid, hydroiodic acid, they cannot attack glass. C. Ordinary glass is alkaline in reaction, and water slowly reacts on glass to form sodium hydroxide. So this is all about the characteristics of glass, and in next lecture I am going to discuss the raw materials, the glass making material, chemical substances which are used, and they are commonly known as batch material. So what are the constituents of batch material? And this is actually under course at BSc or MSc level, that is called industrial chemistry. So nowadays I am delivering the lecture on industrial chemistry, and it is on industrial manufacture of glass, and slowly I will be discussing all the details of different type of furnaces which are used, like pot furnace, tank furnace, and what type of reactions are going on, what type of techniques are there, that I will be discussing one by one. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.